I was in the process of launching my game on the Epic Game Store, but it failed verification as my game was missing achievements. This is apparently a requirement now to launch on Epic. The steps to do this, especially for Unity games, are sparse, and it took me a few days to figure it out without any proper guides or tutorials, which is why I thought I'd make one. Now, I'm not a programmer, so some of my steps may not be the cleanest, or there may be mistakes. I may have gone about this in an unnecessarily roundabout way, but it works. Either way, you're free to offer corrections and tips in the comments section and let others know a better way of achieving this. Anyways, let's get started. Now, first of all, this tutorial assumes that you've already got your game completely set up on Epic, uploaded the builds, etc. This is only for getting the Epic online services and achievements working with your Unity game. To start, we'll be using PlayEveryWare's EOS plugin for Unity. This is an open source plugin that allows your Unity game to communicate with Epic online services or EOS. The first thing we need to do is import the package. We'll be importing it via UPM tarball. The steps for this are laid out on this page. Skip the part about using Git and scroll down here. Open this section and click here to download. You'll need to save the file just outside your assets folder. I've already downloaded it here, so I won't be downloading it again. Now we need to import this. To do this, go to the package manager in Unity, click the plus button, and select add package from tarball. Find the file and click open and import. Once the package has finished importing, you might get this error in the console. At least I did. To fix this, double click on the error to open the script. The error is in the file Epic Online Services Config Editor, line 621. For some reason, it has a problem with adding this period here. I'm not exactly sure why this error comes up and what the best solution would be, but I just went ahead and removed the period which clears up the error. If you have a better solution for this, please share it in the comments. Next, we need to import the sample scenes so that we can test out whether EOS is correctly working and set up in the game. The steps for this are laid out on this page. You just need to go to your package manager, look for packages that are in the project, and find the newly added EOS plugin for Unity. Here, open the dropdown and hit the import button on all the sample packages. Next, you'll want to add them to your build, so go to Assets, Samples, Epic Online Services for Unity, Version Number, and drag and drop all the sample scenes from the standard pack folder, as I understand that these are the only important ones. Next, we need to configure the plugin. The instructions for this are also laid out on the Git page. Open the Dev Portal configuration window through the Tools menu. Now, you'll need to fill in the values for the ones outlined in red, as shown in the instructions page, but it can be hard to find the exact locations for these, even when using the links below. First, fill in the name of your game and the version number. These should be easy. For the rest of the values, you'll want to head to the developer portal and click on the settings icon. Here you'll see the product ID. For the next value, I chose the live value for the sandbox ID. Same for the deployment ID. Remember, I've already created and got my games page approved all the way till the live stage, including uploading the builds and pushing those to live as well. I'm not sure if these values show up without doing that or if the achievements even work without pushing to live, so I'd suggest completing those steps first and getting your coming soon page and a build uploaded first. You have your client ID and client secret on this page as well, but if you haven't created a client yet, you can do so here. Just hit add new client and fill in these fields. I wasn't exactly sure what to fill in for some of these fields, so I kept it simple and named it the same as my game. I don't think it matters. I'll create another one named example just to show you how it's done. You'll also need to create a new client policy. Give it whatever name you like, I'll call it example, and pick a client policy type. I'm guessing for a single player game, the one titled Game Client with Unlock Achievements would be appropriate, and it works fine for me. You don't need to change anything else, just click Add New Client Policy and then hit Add New Client in the next menu. Now you have a new client with a client ID. If you click edit, you'll also be able to see and copy the client secret ID. Go ahead and paste all those values in here. In my case, I didn't need an encryption key, so I left that blank. Once you're done, remember to hit save all changes. Now, we need a new script so the game automatically logs onto EOS. Create a folder somewhere in your project to hold this new script and a few other things that we'll be adding soon. I found this EOSlogin script on this post in the plugins forums. This script is great for testing your in-editor and standalone builds without uploading it to Epic each time. Later on, we'll be replacing this script with one that doesn't force the player to log in each time they launch the game. I've pasted a link to the script and the thread in the description. Next, we'll need to navigate to Packages, Epic Online Services for Unity, Runtime, and add the EOS Manager prefab to each of the game scene. So go to your first scene in the game, look for the prefab from the search bar, switching to the Packages section in the search options, and drag it into your scene. Since this is a package, we won't be able to make changes to this prefab. So just unpack it and create a new prefab. I added it to the same EOS folder as before. You'll also want to add the EOS login script to this prefab, so go ahead and do that. Once that's done, you'll have to add this prefab to each scene of the game. I'm going to do that and skip ahead. Now it's time to try logging in using one of the sample scenes. There are steps to do this in the documentation for the plugin, but it's pretty straightforward. Go to the folder with the sample scene, which will be at Assets, Samples, Epic Online Services Plugin, Version Number, Standard Pack, Scenes, and open the one named Auth and Friends. Run this scene and hit Login. There's a chance that you'll run into this error screen if you haven't configured yet another hidden setting required by Epic. To fix this, go to your dev portal in Epic, click Epic Account Services, and click on Link Clients. I've disconnected mine for this tutorial. You'll just need to click this drop-down menu and select the client you created earlier. Apart from this, you'll also need to set permissions. To be safe, I've enabled all three. Lastly, you'll also need to configure your brand settings. These need approval, but you can add achievements even before these are approved. Go ahead and submit these for verification. And now if we run it, the game is able to log into Epic without any issues. You can ignore these verification problems for now, as that will be fixed once Epic reviews your brand settings. And that's it, we're logged in. Now we'll need to create the actual achievements. I've already created mine, but the process is pretty simple, especially if you've created achievements for Steam before. You'll need to create an achievement name for each achievement, and this name will be used when unlocking them from the game, so keep it in mind. I'll name this one Example. You'll need to also give these locked and unlocked icons. I'm just going to pick a random one from this example. Rest of the stuff here is pretty straightforward. Then you also need to link these to the store. Epic achievements add up to an overall account XP, and each game's achievements need to contribute a total of 1000 XP. So give your achievements different values so that they add up to a total of 1000. I've already done that, so giving this example a value of 5 takes me over the limit to 1005. I'm just gonna go ahead and delete this example now. If you like, you can push the achievements on this page to the live stage. Now, if you run the achievement sample scene from Unity, you should be able to see your achievements on the screen. First, you may have to log in again. And there it is. The achievements are visible in the sample scene. I've already unlocked a few of them, so let's try unlocking one of the locked ones and see if it changes its color. And it does, which means achievements are officially working in the game, and the game is able to communicate with the Epic online services. We can also try to run this sample scene in a build, which will allow us to test out the achievement unlock with the overlay and sound. So go to the build settings and uncheck all the other scenes and hit build. Now in the build, you can see that it brings up the actual login screen for Epic. Once you've logged in, you'll be able to see your achievements. You'll also notice the online now notification, confirming the connection with EOS is working. So let's try unlocking one of the locked achievements. And there it is, with the overlay and the sound and everything. Now the last step is to be able to unlock specific achievements manually from specific points in the game. For that we'll need a script. Create a script named EOS Unlock Achievement in the same folder as before. I found help for writing the script on this forum thread. I've already written it up, so I'm just going to paste it in. I'll also add the script in the description below. This is the method that you'll need to call whenever you want to unlock an achievement. How you go about this part will probably differ from my steps because I use an asset called Adventure Creator for scripting. Either way, from this point on, things should be simple, whatever method you use. Even if you are not using Adventure Creator, stick around till the end of the video as we'll be replacing the EOS login script as mentioned before. To do this using Adventure Creator, create a new game object called, say, Epic Achievements, and then add the new script to it. You'll also need to create a prefab so that you can add it to every scene that has achievements. So go ahead and do that first. Then go to your action list, add an object call event action at the point you need the achievement unlocked. For this test, I'm just going to add it here after the main menu opens. Type in the name of the achievement as stored in your achievements page on the dev portal. Now go ahead and build to give it a try. And it works, the achievement is unlocked. Before you create a final build to upload to Epic, replace the EOS login script in EOS Manager prefab with this Epic Session Controller script, which I also found by digging around the EOS plugin forums. This is also linked in the description. Once that's done, build, upload the game to Epic, and you'll see achievements working correctly when you launch the game from the Epic Games Launcher. And there you go, Epic achievements in your Unity game. I hope you found this tutorial useful. Like I said, adding achievements was super confusing for me and it took me days to figure it out. And I would have loved a complete video tutorial or a guide for it at the time, which is why I decided to make this video. I might have got stuff wrong, so if you spot anything, let us know in the comments below to help the others out. And if you like to support me, maybe check out Unwording on Epic. I'll leave a link to that and my other games in the description below as well. Thanks for watching.